Yes, I am Dr. Kumudhara Rao, faculty, A.B. Shetty Memorial Institute of Dental Sciences, UB University, Bangalore. My co-authors are Professor Dr. Mahabalesh Shetty, A.C. American Medical Academy, UB Professor Dr. U.S. Krishna Nayak, Subhash Babu, and Dr. Prashant Shetty. Next slide, please. Now, coming to the introduction, that is, in legal medicine, the importance of forensic dentistry has become very evident, and the identification of unidentified bodies as identifying human remains which is of unknown origin is very difficult. This lack of positive identification has come with the very positive representation of the data from facial approximation, which is also called as facial reconstruction, facial reproduction, or facial restoration. The representation of the face from skeletonized skull of an individual using facial soft tissue thickness data. Now, the facial approximations, as we have designed using 3D sculptic techniques, and there are many other various researchers who have designed facial approximations. Now, this has been enhanced by the availability of modern, well-defined, consistent, and statistically robust FSTT data, which may be manual or digital techniques, or which may be using artificial intelligence as well. But in such a scenario, now cone beam computed tomography imaging is comparatively economic and non-invasive, with many other specific advantages of the 3D imaging. Next slide, please. Now, coming to the aim of my study, the aim was to compile a set of facial soft tissue thickness data of Karnataka population, and the objective was to evaluate and compare the facial soft tissue thickness for sexual dimorphism using CBCT among the Karnataka population. Next, please. Now, coming to literature review, there have been many researchers who have tried facial soft tissue thickness either by manual methods and virtual methods, as I have told before. Now, Kararosha M.A.H.R., he had sexual dimorphism by using spiral CT on mandibular images, whereas Steinem et al. On white South Africans for mandibular measurements. So there have been various racial and ethnic anthropological measurements taken for various research for checking and tabulating the facial soft tissue thickness data. The Helizonitis J.J. et al., he did on 170 lateral cephalometric, that is radiographs, wherein he had calculated skeletal and soft tissue components. Oliveira et al. On mandibular images using CBCT. Park CL et al., he had done on FBI samples of cranial CT scans on 388 living adults on modern American adult population. And Ryan J.S. et al. On Egyptian population using ultrasonic imaging. So various people have used manual methods and imaging methods for which they have their own population data for facial soft tissue thickness analysis. Next slide. Now, coming to my study, we have done this study with CBCT data of patients visiting the Department of Oral Medicine and Radiology in A.B. Shetty Memorial Institute of Dental Sciences. 56 subjects from Karnataka were analyzed using MIMOSEFT software following the CBCT imaging of the patients. The inclusion criteria were the subjects from 18 to 30 years of age and who had visited ABSM IDS for CBCT images, who were indicated for the CBCT images. Exclusion criteria were the congenital anomalies, the syndromes, orofacial pathologies were excluded, and subjects who had undergone orthodontic correction, the history of trauma, surgical intervention, and exposure to radiotherapy. Subjects not willing to participate in the study were also eliminated from the, included under the exclusion criteria. Next, please. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Yeah, now coming to the facial soft tissue thickness. Now this is the anterior and the lateral view. Please go back. Yes. You can go back.
Ma'am, I think there is some technical glitch. That is why you just need to let me know that where I need to stop. Is this the current slide you want to read?
Can you go back one slide back? Yes. Okay. Now coming to the clinical Yeah, the next slide. Yes, this one. For the time being, please let it be this one. Now, the clinical examination, the case history was recorded to rule out those subjects who fall under the respective criteria. Weight and height of the subject spore was also recorded, and we have recorded even the basal metabolic index. The craniometric and capillometric soft landmarks were recorded on the patients using after the CBCT. The CBCT data of the patients was obtained using the ProMax 3D MID, that is Planmeca machine. The standard protocol that was used was the full field of view, and voxel size was 400 mm and exposure time was 4.7 seconds. The heart tissue and the soft tissue landmarks were marked, and FSTT measurements were obtained using NemoCeph 3D software. Next slide, please.
We are on the next slide, ma'am.
Now, yes, I can see now. So this is the anterior and the lateral aspect of the...
Kumudana, I just want to inform you, yes, the slight movement have been done accordingly, but due to the network issue from your end, you will be getting it a bit late, okay?
No problem.
Yeah, thank you. Go ahead.
Continue, yes. This is the anterior and the lateral aspect of the measurements that I have considered a diagrammatic representation. Just click, please, once again. So we can see here the CBCT post, that is NemoCeph software analysis. We have done the following measurements wherein many unilateral and bilateral landmarks were marked for capillometric, and that is the soft tissue landmarks and heart tissue landmarks were marked, and FSTT data was recorded in various sections so as to accumulate the data in a three-dimensional view. Next slide, please. The statistical analysis was carried out. The mean, that is a standard deviation, and the standard error along with the confidence interval with different measurements was documented. Comparison of facial FSTT measurements was made by using a student t-test. Association between the categorical variable was also done using a chi-square test, and p, that is less than 0.5, was considered to be statistically significant, and data was analyzed using the statistical SPSS software. Next slide, please. Now we can see, I think the slide has been changed, right?
No, we are on the next slide only.
I am done with every click, but hopefully everybody can see it.
You want the slide where there is data is mentioned, right?
No, I had done with every click for it to be appearing. Here I can see everything together, but it's
very small. Because it was mentioned here. Because it was mentioned here, we remove the transitions so that we won't face
any kind of problem. No problem. If everybody can appreciate, I would be very happy. So we can see here there was... the p-value was very significant when it came to the height, the weight, and also many other which have been highlighted in red, many other components which have been highlighted in red. So the sexual dimorphism, please, the next slide, please. Now coming to the descriptive statistics, 50 out of the 56 subjects, 28 were males and 28 were females, and the mean values of most of the, that is parameters, was seen to be higher among the males than the females in the Karnataka population. There were statistically significant results which was seen with respect to the group statistics for sexes under the variables height, weight, the rhinion, the MP, and wherein we can see the respective values which were significant between the sexes in the Karnataka population respectively. Next, please. Now, coming to the discussion, with increasingly sophisticated crimes, new investigation techniques in forensic science needs to be developed, as well as existing technology needs to be refined, that is applying the benefits of the emergence of new technological resources for the same. Coming to facial approximation, which is designed using 3D sculpting techniques, would be enhanced by availability of modern, well-defined, consistent, and statistically robust soft tissue data, which is very important when it comes to specific population. The facial reconstruction benefited further when three-dimensional data and statistics were used as an aid for the same. Thus, it was of great importance for FSTT data to be population specific and be recorded in all three dimensions, and it should be recorded and maintained as a data in all the governmental organizations. Next, please. Now, where we have considered NemoSafe orthodontic software for analysis of the facial soft tissue thickness data, which revealed significant difference in the mean FSTT values above the p-values among the sexes of our study population suggestive of sexual dimorphism. The data set of our study was representative of adults belonging to Karnataka population, which will aid in future facial reconstructions, which will facilitate individual identification and forensic application. Also, the same study will have to be carried out in bigger numbers for it to be very specific with specific results. Now, our study has been similar to all the studies that I have mentioned in most of the studies of which has been mentioned in the review of literature previously, and wherein sexual dimorphism was also seen with respect to the facial soft tissue thickness data. Now, coming to the conclusion, a constant challenge in the routine forensic investigation in India is the personal identification of unknown human skeletal remains, especially in those cases with non-availability of any antemortem record. In scenario where only skull is found, probable facial recognition is made possible digitally by reconstructing the contours of the skull's soft tissues by the application of FSTT data sets based on individual type of populations. The significance of this art of facial forensic reconstruction of forensic facial or facial approximation using CBCT is to serve as an essential tool in forensic identification, especially when there are no other means of identification. Next slide, please. These are my references. Next, please. I think the first slide is missing. Thank you.